Harpers Ferry, West Virginia. Back in the Civil War, there might have been people in there. Stone walls are unreal. A lot of hard work went into the labor here. There's a lot to see in this town. Civil War history, a haunted church, this church, St. Peter's Roman Catholic Church. See? It was turned into a hospital, if I have my history right, during the Civil War. And we have the railroad, the river, a lot of taverns. This town has got it all. Having a ball in Harpers Ferry. Y'all have a great day. Doodlebug's Adventures out. It's a beautiful little place. It's packed with tons of history. Someone told me at lunch that some of the buildings are haunted, but I didn't see any ghosts. But it's a beautiful place. You could take days or a week to explore the whole thing. Beautiful little hiking trails. Doodlebug's Adventure gives it a 10. It's got everything. Scenery, great food, great people, great hiking. Y'all have a great day.
Take me down to Harpers Ferry, let me revel in my dreams. sharpened ears. The fate of Harpers Ferry has been linked to the natural environment. For most of its history, the town prospered as a beneficiary of abundant water power and navigable waterways. At other times, floods roared through the valleys, nearly bringing the town to extinction. Floods are a natural component of life in this river town. These hillsides all around you drain into the Shenandoah River. The railroad tracks off to the right still carry freight south to the Shenandoah Valley and beyond. In the 19th century, it was known as the Winchester and Potomac Railroad and was used by both sides during the Civil War. Look for the river through the trees ahead and to the right. The narrow marsh or wetland between the park road and the railroad provides refuge to a variety of plants, fish, insects, and animals. Today's wetland was once an open waterway known as the Shenandoah Canal. Boats navigated through this canal as a bypass around the rapids of the river. The canal also channeled river water toward the mills and factories downstream. Businesses depend on these rivers as the source of energy to run the machinery that flourished here during the first half of the 19th century. In the early years, the canals and rivers were keys to the local economy. After the Civil War, the railroads and turnpikes became more important. Today, the trains still roll by while modern highways and bridges crisscross the river. Imagine the scene a century ago when water flowed through a canal right next to the park road. Where trees are today, great factories once stood, harnessing the energy of moving water to power their machinery. John Hall's rifle factory was located in this area. It produced weapons with interchangeable parts and revolutionized the industrial process around the world. Watch for the stone ruins along the right. These structures once supported a water-powered mill where huge turbines ground logs in a paper pulp until 1935. The next year, the highest flood in recorded history devastated the building. The 1936 flood destroyed any hope of renewing the industrial promise of Virginia Center. Other private industries flourished here. The steep walls of rock along the left side of the road were used to build canal walls, houses, and factories that once filled nearly every available space along the river's edge. Downtown Harpers Ferry lies just ahead. Walk to Jefferson Rock, where Thomas Jefferson described the view as one of the most stupendous scenes in nature. Visit John Brown's Ford, the site of a desperate attack against slavery in 1859. Don't hesitate to ask a ranger about the history of Storer College, and consider a side trip to Bolivar Heights. For orientation, exhibits, and trail maps to all of these areas and the surrounding hillsides, stop at the Information Center in the Mascaronos House. Visit the bookstore for postcards, videos, books, and gifts. And most importantly, have a safe and pleasant visit.